De olsun. Ucu kadar. Some good association with all the devotees. Getting some pleasure in your practicing life. Always, who is the pure devotee? Actually, they also want some association. I heard from Gurudev. Sometimes, Param Guru Siddhartha Goswami Maharaj's god brother, they all, time to time, they, Param Guru Maharaj Siddhartha Goswami Maharaj was living in the cottage, bank of the Ganges, small cottage. And all his god brothers, all time, they came to see our Guru Maharaj. That's, I heard from Gurudev, Siddhartha Bhakti Kamal Madhusudan Maharaj, he is coming from the gate and paying full obeisance, always. Full dandavat. Even Kishudas Babaji Maharaj, he always, from Navadvip to Hapaniya, Siddhartha Maharaj's birthplace, going to walking, and he is doing kirtan, Krishna, 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 Namo, Kirtanam, Ramo, Ramo, Ganarama, Dibba, Sanda, Nartanam, Jatra, Tatra, Krishna, Namo, Ganoloka, Nistaram, Premadhamo, Devameva, Nohu, and he is starting from Navadvip and finishing all Premadhamo, Estrata, he is all his mind, and he is starting from Navadvip and finishing in Hapaniya. And he going to Hapaniya and he is searching there, Siddhartha Param Guru Maharaj, Siddhartha Goswami Maharaj, who is pond he bath, who is toilet he go bathroom, and who is school he reading, he is searching all of this. Siddhartha Maharaj was asking, you are my god brother Maharaj, you are going to Hapaniya, that is okay, but who is school I am reading, who is playground like playing football, why you are searching that kind of things? And then Babaji Maharaj told Maharaj, when I am reciting your sloka, that I am remembering my Rupa Goswami, and I am searching where Rupa Goswami is born, where Rupa Goswami, which pond is bathing, that it is not my offense. Maybe. If I offense, no problem. And one time, Srila Asi Bhaktivinoda Swami Maharaj, Srila Prabhupada, that time he came to preaching in the West, and after coming back to India, and he sent news to our Param Guru Maharaj, I am coming. And Param Guru Maharaj became very happy. And also, Swami Maharaj, Asi Bhakti Swami Maharaj, he became very happy because he wants to approach what he preaching, what he did in the West, what kind of preaching, what kind of enthusiasm they are doing, accepting this Krishna consciousness. They, Param Guru Maharaj also want to hear. And Asi Bhakti Swami Maharaj, Srila Prabhupada wants to approach everything to Siddhartha Goswami Maharaj. One time he came and Asi Bhakti Swami Maharaj came to Siddhartha Goswami Maharaj. And Siddhartha Maharaj think that time only two rooms, that's old building, two rooms, and on Nath Mundir have a small room. But where Swami, Resi Bhakti Swami Maharaj, he came from the West, where he will sleep, or where he will give the bed, he is like thinking. And his own bed is cleaning, and his straw mat is broken. Mat? Yes, he's broken. And where he will give sleeping, that he is like chanchal, what it's called? And like anxiety, and then while he sleep, and he clean his own bed. Siddhartha Maharaj clean his own door, Swami Maharaj came from the West, I'm giving some nourishment. And Swami Maharaj, even him, he did not sit in his bed, because he sat down in downstairs, and he told my Gurudev, Gaurangi, where is your bed? You became crazy, I will sleep his bed, I will sat down his bed, I not go. Where is your bed, where is your room, I want to go there. At Nath Mandir, Gurudev has a small room, and then Gurudev take Asi Bhakti Swami Maharaj his own room. And that kind of love and affection had that among the god brothers like this. And all of them god brothers, they always coming to Siddhartha Goswami Maharaj. Even all of the Param Guru Maharaj's god brothers, Gurudev, our Gurudev got opportunity to serve them. For this way, he is this main servitor, Guru Maharaj's servitor. Our Gurudev also got opportunity to serve them. And one time Gurudev told me, Prabhupada has on gun. Bhaktivinoda Saraswati Thakur has own gun. Yeah. Prabhupada never gave anybody, he gave his disciple to Bhaktisananda Goswami Maharaj. And Bhaktisananda Goswami Maharaj has so much personality, and like everybody he is afraid to him. Because nobody, actually even all the senior devotees, they are also afraid to Sananda Goswami Maharaj. That means he is Brahmachari also. But he took later sannyas from Siddhartha Goswami. One day Gurudev is asking to Goswami Maharaj, can you give me the gun to me? Gurudev asking to that Gosai Maharaj. Can you give me your gun to me? Gosai Maharaj is like this looking. The one who cannot talk with me. And there's such a small boy is talking to me. Can you give me gun to me? And Gosai Maharaj is, and he is thinking about that boy is very, no fearful boy. And he happily he gave to gun to our Gurudev. And Gosai Maharaj became surprised. And then he happily he gave to gun to him. And Gosai Maharaj told not to kill the man. That's why he got good affection from all the god brothers. If you not go to the devotees, how will you know Krishna consciousness? How will you practice? If you not get the pure association, then how will you get the good consciousness, good Krishna? How will you go to Guru the practice way? If you not get the good association, if you will get the pure association, you will get the pure devotion. On Bhakti Madhav Puri Maharaj, he wrote very on good article. I saw his English article, Bhakti Madhav Puri. One devotee went to the barber shop to shave his hair, shave his
face. Maharaj in India.
Yeah, India. Yes. One devotee went to the barber shop. Mm-hmm. And then India, like barber shop he went. And many are in the barber shop, they are waiting, only one barber. And they somebody reading newspaper, and somebody, and then even they saw, that barber saw his tilak, kontimala, jealousy. And then that barber told, when he saw that devotee, barber told, no, in this world no Lord, no Krishna, no Bhagavan, no Bhagavan. And that devotee, one day he went to some train station, and he saw, one big crazy person, like beard, like hair, never 10 years, he never shaved. That kind of man got crazy. He found one crazy that he did never 10 years, he never shaved. Big hair, big beard like this. And then he found that boy and found that man. Then he catch him and bring to the barber shop. And then the devotee told, in this world, no barber. And then barber told, yes, I am the barber. Yesterday you shave, I shave you. I am barber. Why you told no barber here? I am barber. Yeah, and then somebody told, if you are barber, then why that man is long hair, long beard? That barber told, that man did not come to me. How I shave him? Then that devotee told, then how you know no Bhagavan is, you never go to the Bhagavan. You never go to the Bhagavan, Lord's devotee. You never go to the Krishna's devotee, you never go to the Krishna's temple. If you go, then you can understand Krishna is existing or not existing. You can understand, if you get association from the Krishna's devotee, then you will understand that why Krishna have or not. That's you can understand, otherwise you will not get. If you then, that man did not come to you, then you can understand. If you cannot go to the Krishna's temple, you can understand Krishna is have or not. That's a good example, huh? Actually, this Krishna consciousness is coming through practicing. Practicing Krishna Anushilan. Practicing not Krishna consciousness. Not necessarily go to the temple. It was there. They will sometimes, you can realize, he also, some devotees not usually not coming to the temple, not getting the good association, Krishna consciousness will be disappeared. So those Paramahamsas gave the good name, or Sangha name, Krishna Anushilan Sangha. Anushilan means practicing. Or Sangha is practicing Krishna consciousness.